And gentlemen, and ladies, and gents, hope everybody's doing all right today. It's been an interesting day, to say the least. And I could say a whole lot more leastly. Ladies and gentlemen, I wanted to talk about something today. Go back into the month of December, towards the end, after the 23rd of December. And what you're going to find is that there was a comment made by this person regarding the distractions that are portrayed by government, how they were talking about the crisis, the financial crisis in the United States, and how they were doing a government shutdown. I hope you guys remember that in December, where they shut it down for a weekend or something like that. And it was on the news. That's all they covered the whole weekend. And then we had this thing about me doing a video telling everybody that you need to pay attention. That's a distraction. This is what they normally do. So they gave us a distraction. And what did they do? Trump passed some stupid bill, and then they passed the tax bill, and they threw all of that at people all at once to make people think that they were doing something beneficial, that he had accomplished something. Do you notice how they're trying to prop him up now as if he's somebody great? As if his credit rating and credit approval and public opinion is swaying in the opposite direction? Didn't they do the same thing with Bush when he was in office? Did he not have the lowest approval rating of any president prior to him? And look at his second year in office, all of a sudden his approval rating went up. Man, imagine that. This is what they do, ladies and gentlemen. They put somebody in there, and then now they try to make that individual look like they're presidential. Okay? And then now they're having this attorney say that she paid the prostitute. Excuse me? It doesn't matter who paid the prostitute. It matters what did you pay the prostitute for. I'm just saying, you know, garden tool is a garden tool. I ain't never paid no garden tool to do no work in my backyard, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry, that was a bad comment. I apologize, I didn't mean it that way. I had to stop myself because some of y'all will sit up there and take it there. I'm taking it back. All right, I take it back. You ain't gonna take nothing I say nowhere. See, that's the problem with doing something live, with me just speaking, especially when I'm tired, y'all. Look. Today we got the news that there was a shooting in Florida. If you go back to roughly about December 29th, I did a video explaining to you guys exactly what they were getting ready to do. How that you were going to start hearing about mass shootings and shootings here and there because they need to make gun control an issue. Now watch you hear Congress talking about gun control. We've already heard them talk about it last month. This is the beginning of the year still. This is February. We haven't even made it to the 15th of February. We got one more month of winter. March 14th, there is no more winter, people. Spring is here. Even though spring doesn't start for several days after that, usually the 14th of March is when there's no more spring. I mean, no more winter. All right. So, still the beginning of the year. And we got that going on in Florida. And then all of a sudden, oh, God, his last name is Cruz. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, Hispanic people do not commit mass murder in the United States. But what about the other incident at the nightclub? Exactly. It doesn't happen, people. That's not how that culture operates. You guys just really need to pay attention. Go and look at the history of the individuals who commit mass murder.
Well, they've been mass murderers who've been Hispanic.
That's right. But very far, few, and in between. Ain't like it is these days, is it? The statistics do not add up.
But they say they have confidential determination that this was the individual who did it, and the reason why he did it, we don't know yet, but we're going to find out.
They already gave up his name, and the day ain't even over. Guys, that's not how a police investigation works. They don't operate that way, but the news media had all the information before you got it. Just like 9/11, they already had the information that Building 7 had fallen before it had even thought about falling. I mean, smoke wasn't even coming from the building, and they were talking about Building Number 7 already having collapsed. Okay, the first building in history. Sorry, I apologize. The third building in history to collapse as a result of fire. Okay? And it wasn't even struck by a plane. But they reported it on the news over an hour before it even happened. They are psychic, ladies and gentlemen. The same as I could tell you exactly what was getting ready to happen before it even happened. That they were getting ready to do some more mass shootings. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. Look at how short a period of time they've had a mass shooting in the United States.
Did you see me?
Now, technically, all they're doing is giving other people ideas. But he's going to have some psychological problems, and it's going to be an issue. And, oh, by the way, his parents are either going to be illegal, undocumented immigrants or undocumented aliens. See, if they're from Europe, they're undocumented immigrants. If they're from Mexico, they're illegal aliens. So I need you to pay attention to what's going on here. If you don't see the racism here, then let's go to Greg Popovich. Let me tell you something. I did not know that that man was as honorable on a certain level as he is. He told the truth. Greg Popovich, you guys don't know who Greg Popovich is? Let me explain it to you. He's the coach that coached Tim Duncan and that coached the Admiral David Robinson.
Robinson.
Two very great basketball players. That man has conducted a very fine team over there in San Antonio. And as racist as I have the opinion that Texas actually is, to have Greg Popovich talk about the United States being a very racist country, my hat is off to that young man. Because he actually spoke the truth from the pulpit of the front row and not the back row. This man, this is not the first time he's done it. He did it before the national finals, and now he's going to be the Olympic coach. And he's saying this now. Watch and see how they curtail him, because they cannot have that image tarnished.
The land of the free, home of the brave, the most racist free people on the planet, the most racist brave people on the planet.
That's what he said. And people can't get around it. They don't want to accept the truth. Then some people accept it. They'll say, well, yeah, it's this and that. But in other countries, well, he was not comparing America to other countries. He was comparing America by saying it's a racist country to the image they try to portray. Like they're better than everybody else. Ladies and gentlemen, what happened today was a shame. But we are living in that period of time to where this is what they do. Okay, but look, all of you will forget about it tomorrow. Those of you who don't live in Florida, please, you'll forget about it. The only way you're going to remember it is because the news is going to highlight it. But give it a month. Nobody's talking about Las Vegas no more, except for when they compare this to that and they start talking about gun control. Go to Fox News. I'm not watching the news, ladies and gentlemen, but I guarantee you, you turn to Fox News, they're talking about gun control. I don't care about Fox News or CNN. I don't care, but I do know how they spin things. Ladies and gentlemen, it's all about spin. Now, I want to tell you guys something, and this is aside from everything else, and this is not talking about the organization known as SACCON.
Look at that little cute kitty looking at the computer. Oh, look at that. He must be reading his emails. Yep, because that's Gmail right there. Don't you guys recognize Gmail? Yeah, he's reading his email.
I'm just kidding, kitty. You get it, kid? Oh, okay, you got it. My bad. Ladies and gentlemen, on the SACCON website, we've had a lot of people asking a lot of questions. And so the other night, temporarily, we put up the information regarding questions and answers. So in the question and answer section, I added in a lot of the original questions from the actual people. Someone took a look at it and thought that it was unprofessional. Now we're getting ready to clean it up. I just had to
put some questions and answers there so that people could understand what other people were thinking. Now, we could have put it in our words, but that's not the way you do things. We have to make sure people understand that this was coming from real people. We didn't put the person's name or email address, but we put some, not a lot. I mean, we get hundreds of those emails. We didn't put 100 up there. We only put a handful, and we put ones that came from probably October and November of last year. Nothing from the current year, but we still put the questions up there that people were asking. And when we put those questions up there, we tried to provide a general answer for now. We have a team that's working on updating the site, and so they're going to reword it, but I'm going to try to keep the comment from you all. When we put the questions up there, we're going to try to keep it in the context for which the question was asked. Because if you don't understand the context, you won't understand the answer. I'm hoping some of you understand that. So someone suggested that it might appear unprofessional. Ladies and gentlemen, it would be unprofessional and disingenuous of us if we were to try to portray it something other than what it was. It's called frequently asked questions. So what we did is we put the actual live question of the live individual. You saw the video I did earlier today where the individual and I are actually having an actual conversation. You've seen me do this. You've seen me ask the person. Well, I didn't ask this guy. I told him I was putting that up there. Let y'all see what I go through when people call me. Be wanting to be telling me about how to do what I've already told them to do when they got the information from me. Okay, well, that's what I was doing. And so I have this habit because I'm the one in charge of the emails. And so because the frequently asked questions are those that we get in emails, I decided to put up the actual question from the person. Now, we have a team of individuals who work at SATCOM. They handle several different departments. That team will be working on the emails and rewording them. Now, again, this video is not a SATCOM video. I'm just helping you guys understand that we're trying to keep it not real, because Dave Chappelle told us what happens when keeping it real goes wrong, and we ain't trying to do no kind of keeping it real like that. Hey, Valerie and Lori, I wanted to tell you I was thinking about you tonight, was going to call you, but I'm just too tired. So Valerie, Lori, there's a shout out to two of you. Okay, you've been on my mind, and just want to let you know I've been that busy, so that's why you ain't heard from me. Now, the rest of you, if I ain't shout out your name, and if you jealous, you just gonna have to blame it on Valerie and Lori. They are from Michigan, okay? So you just yell all the way out to Michigan, tell Valerie and Lori how much you hate them because I mentioned their names and I didn't mention yours. Just like I mentioned Jordan's name, and then because Jordan is the one who found the address. And then I mentioned John's name because John... Amon. So like Amon Ra. So Amon Bey. Anyway, I mentioned their names because they contributed something. But we have now people, because I mentioned people's names, they want to contribute stuff to me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have a chance, an opportunity to read all of the things that people send me. It's too much. And some of you are writing me paragraphs and paragraphs and paragraphs. Sorry, I don't have time to read the paragraphs. It's just not possible. I just don't have the time. And I've been so distracted lately. But now I have to hone in my focus. So I'm not taking on any new cases, not taking on any new projects. Anybody call me, I fulfilled every obligation I was obligated to fulfill. Let me make sure that everybody knows this, because there's nobody gonna tell me, oh no, you still have to do this and that for me. No, I ain't gotta do for nobody. Sorry, that reminds me of the way my sister would put it to me. And I'm sorry, but that is the way she would put it. But I ain't got to do nothing for nobody. I fulfilled my obligation. I kept my word. Even when I had to do someone's papers today, which stressed me out greatly, I took the time to do a video to show you guys how an individual paid off his automobile just by following the instructions on videos. You heard him, the videos in 2012. He went back to the how to pay off this and pay off that video, and he followed the steps. They haven't changed. Ladies and gentlemen, they haven't changed. That's why I played that for you. Everybody's, how do you do this and how do you do that? Look, the money orders.
Oh, sorry. Oh God, I'm so glad that I just remembered this. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so glad. I always do it at the end of videos. I just got off the phone today and I talked with a particular company. The reason why when you guys are doing these money orders and things, the reason, and I told you, they just changed the system on you. I found out tonight what they did. If you are trying to put money into an account, such as your pay your phone bill or go and deposit something into some, you have to do it as if you're making a direct deposit from an employer on an employee's account. There is a process for doing it. I know I done gave the beans and spilled it and given it to, ladies and gentlemen, that's what they did. They didn't change the account number. They created a new method of which those accounts receive money. So like you have a credit card that you want to do a direct deposit into your credit card. They won't let you do a direct deposit into your credit card unless it's coming the way the process is for an employer to send a direct deposit. Okay, there is a particular process or particular portal for which direct deposits from employers are done. So it has to be done that way. I promise you, I got this from the horse and from the horse's mouth, and the breath on that horse was something else. Oh, Lordy, let me tell you, I don't know what, how many apples that thing was eating, but it was eating apples and crabgrass or something. Okay, anyway, ladies and gentlemen, when I heard that information, and that was tonight, it wasn't yesterday, it wasn't last week, I just got that tonight because I ran into a particular situation to where I had to inquire about something, and this is how I get information, people. The way I communicate with these individuals, they volunteer the information to me without me asking about it. Okay, I can't teach you how to do that. I can just tell you that's what happens. All right, so there you go. I told you the black cat thing. They changed the system. That's why your money orders are not working. That's why your A for V's are not working. That's why your treasury rally numbers and your TDAs and all of that is not working. They changed the system. But I told you guys they changed the system. I told you they changed how the routing number and everything goes. They switched the process on you. And they simply didn't tell you, but they told the companies what they did. So guess what? That information can never remain secret. So I'm telling you, okay? And I'm not gonna advertise this. People are just gonna have to come back and listen on their own. I'm just gonna give this a simple title and put this video up because I'm sorry, people. I'm just exhausted. Nonstop, nonstop, nonstop.
Well, you always complain about...
That's right, I'm gonna keep complaining because it's my video, my television. I have the right to complain. Ain't that right, old timer? You see, he ain't got nothing to complain about sitting up there just putting a line in the middle of the water and just watching that line just sit in the water and ain't moving or nothing. Okay, and they just sitting up in that house. Ain't no smoke coming out of the chimney. They must not be able to have no wood, must not have no gas furnace or anything else in that house, because ain't no smoke coming out of that chimney, but there's a lot of frost on that ground. Something wrong there. And don't look at the snowman. He ain't even melting, so you know they freezing in that house. Got all of the lights on, too. Look, all them lights on. Look at that electric bill gonna be something. I'm sorry. Just joking, just kidding. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you all to have a good evening. Just thought I'd give this information to you. I hope this information was somewhat helpful. Please don't let the events around this so-called country and this world. They're getting ready to increase the military spending in the United States. You guys don't see what's happening, but I'm going to tell you what's happening. When they increase the military spending in the United States, what are they going to be spending money on? You think they're going to be spending it on guns and missiles and all that? No, they're not, ladies and gentlemen. They're spending it on electronic warfare.
okay? Electronics. They're not going to be spending it on rockets. They're spending it on the chips and all of that stuff and the military equipment that they're going to use in the country, not outside the country, on the people. Remember, they're about to wage a war on the people. I didn't make this up, Agenda 21. So they're going to be spending it on that technology. If you don't believe me, pay attention to what they're saying they're spending the money on and why they say they're spending cyber crimes. Okay, pay attention. This is what they're planning. They're letting you know in advance. You just have to be able to not speculate. You just have to understand how they think and how they word things. And once you get that, you don't get displayed or all of that mislaid and misdirected and mispointed and all. You don't get none of that. Okay? Because that's what's been happening. That's what's been happening to people. So people like me sit up and we say, hey guys, this is what's going on. This is what you need to pay attention to. This is what you need to be aware of. Okay? So I hope the information in this video has proved helpful to some of you. If it has, hey, I did my job for the week. Gotta go. Take care of yourselves. Have a good day. Have a good life. Have a good night. And I'm going to have a good bye. Adios. Arrivederci. Sayonara. You know, all that other good stuff.